Who am I? Christopher the culprit Mofelt. What am I? I'm a producer, I'm an artist, I'm a writer, visionary, mentor to other artists. And right now you're watching Closer to My Dream, the documentary.
Alright, yeah, we in. Cheers. This is the Sess Video Show.
Yeah.
Got a special guest tonight. Fellas, introduce yourself.
Christopher Mofelt the culprit.
Right, what's up?
This is Liz the All-Star, man. Checking you out, holla at me,
yeah. And to understand more about me, you gotta understand where I came from, what I've been through, the struggle.
Talk to the people, let them know what's up.
I left King Records, went out as a single act, started touring, and everything started processing in the right direction. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
And
you said you was on Dick Clark?
I was on the Dick Clark show. I did quite a few shows.
All right. When was this?
This was back in the 70s.
All right. So
you were signed to King Records.
King Records, right.
All right,
man. So what brought you back into the music industry?
Well, I made a comeback. You know, it's in your heart. Entertainment, show business is in your heart. And I couldn't get out of it. I had to stay in it. So I came up on my nephews. My nephews is the reason why I'm here. And they're achieving now. They're moving in the right direction. And I'm tickled to death.
So you're reliving your stardom.
My stardom, my career.
It came to me in a vision. In that vision, became a dream. The dream came to me. I knew everything I needed to do, but I knew that I didn't have the resources. But I just used my faith. I exercised it, and I started working.
Videos and tees, then we poly over G's, making moves overseas. Want to walk in my shoes like they part of my team. When I put the work in and plotted the schemes, when we the one to lay the groundwork and follow the dream.
So I usually work with other artists and stuff like that. You know, I'm influential in the hood and on the underground Philly scene. I'm known for filming DVDs such as Hood Politics. The first mixtape was called BZ. The mixtape 2002, Hood Politics 2005, the mixtape. We did the DVD in 2006 along with the mixtape Still Politicking. 2007, I decided to try to step it up higher. That's my image, and we filmed We On Fire the DVD.
To bring you this important message.
Mental music. Corporate shit. Remix.
You ain't got no will. You ain't got no bottle. Let's just be honest.
That accumulated a nice amount of success, but we still didn't attain our goal of, you know, being globally recognized. So I felt like it still was more ground to cover. 2009, we recorded Three the Hard Way with Nolly Jules and Cartier. At that time, it wasn't even known for artists from the North or the East Coast to work with Down South artists. We started working with Down South artists. I was producing tracks for them. They was filling the music. They started sending tracks up. One of my guys from North Carolina, he came up, spent the whole year with us. We recorded the album. That's right now, it's on that piff.
Tyra Banks blowing ganks, yeah, we crushing the night. Red carpet in the war show, stay away from weirdos. Pay like I weigh, put my money where my mouth is.
After that, I released a few solo albums on iTunes. And that brings you up to Closer to My Dream, Volume 1, which dropped in 2015. That's where the journey begins. Closer to My Dream.
Truly on the rise, you on the power with this guy.
Tell us about your movement, where you guys from, and you know how they got the
concept
with y'all.
Like coming soon, you know what I'm saying? Sandman and the M-Man and the Ultimate, you know, the Incredible Plug, right? Yeah, Sandman and the Incredible Plug tour. Shit about to take over the world, you already know.
You good fellas,
you good fellas. Soft Light.
Right, right.
I even got to get bars if y'all want it, you know what I mean?
How can niggas reach out to you though, man? I mean, you on YouTube or something like that? Cause this joint going worldwide.
Mr. WNR, Mr. Slam on YouTube, Mr. WNR on everything.
On everything.
Okay.
Right.
IJP, know what I'm saying? You already know. Hit my niggas up, man. Sauce.
That's right.
Another dressing on your bitch.
Right.
Let's get the guys over here.
Yeah, let's get the fellas. You know. Let's go.
Instagram, Glenwood only, WOOD only.
Okay.
Beat producer, model, all that shit. All
right.
Everything, tweet the film.
Mental music, you know what I'm saying? With the ghetto star, you know what I'm saying?
Let's go.
Y'all here with ghetto star, mental music, you know what I'm saying?
The culprit.
You know what I'm saying? We Muslims, you know what I'm saying?
Yes. Yeah, that's love. Definitely go ahead and get together with the brothers.
Troy, what's
definitely
up? Give him some wisdom, bro.
This was my first manager.
First of all, a shout out to that performance today. I actually found out it was a daytime party at the last minute, but I know y'all represented. And a shout out go to not just you, Culprit, being the centerpiece like of the movement,
the team,
but to the whole team.
Team, let me get them.
If these boys, these brothers represent, you know what?
They represent.
They really the light. They really the light too.
Everybody, so we
really
all
about
a movement.
It's about them. It's about
no, no, music is the family.
It's a family.
We a movement.
Family.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody gonna eat. When everybody come
eat.
In, they ain't gonna get shitty on y'all. No, everybody gonna get even. They gonna get the breakdown with the breakdown.
Yeah, that's how we do. We
that's
family.
How you do family.
And you got to get out there and work for it. You can't expect shit. You see how they, you
but,
see how we today.
But you got to
see
us
every day. We grinding.
But you got to also understand. You got to also understand. Miracles the fuck happen. Sparks fly. You know what that means? You might be a team member, but a motherfucker with the bankroll tied to a fucking major label. I like you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ain't no disrespect, but I need you to come over here and sign for $2 million. I'm telling
and
you.
If that was to happen,
if
that was to happen,
yeah.
I'll make Chris, any one of these.
Okay,
I better go sign that deal.
Yeah.
I better go sign that deal.
It's here, but it's not here.
That was going to put the team in a position to get us to where we need to be.
And you know what, though?
Do what you got to do now to do a
20-day. Now, my cousin said, get some wisdom. You heard what that young man just said? He said, and that's right, because that's going to have enough money to put the team in position. Mm-hmm. Right there, you know how big a jump that the fuck is?
Yeah.
You know how many niggas fail at the 50-yard line? Right the fuck there?
What?
Do you know how many motherfuckers get
Marshawn Lynch?
They get pre-signed money. They might get like $500,000, and the label throw them a Jeep and a car and tell them, I'll get you a house for $300,000.
Yeah.
What you want?
Yeah, exactly.
You know how many niggas are flip on their own motherfuckers that they done grew up with from the roots?
Yeah.
Right there. That's easy to say out your fucking mouth.
Yeah.
But in reality, that's a big fucking canyon to jump.
Yeah,
I'm telling you, it's a test.
Yeah.
That canyon is a test. You know why? Because it's going to make a real motherfucker show up and be a real motherfucker.
Yeah, show you.
But if he's fake,
real
but
shit.
If he's fake and he going for the paper,
yeah, the money going
to
change.
Gonna turn on you like
the money
going to
change.
Cobra.
And you see, we doing it
like
now before the money. We already traveling and doing what we doing before the money.
Listen, we got a million stories we can tell, but we ain't going to tell
it. I
came from the struggle, man, since 10 years.
He told me to give y'all the
real shit. Every day, and it might not be every day we see each other. We keep it 100 around this joint.
He told me to give y'all the real shit. My cousin said, you know what, give him the real shit. Well, I'm going to give him the real shit. That's a big fucking leech. He said it right, but don't go by that one sentence.
Let me say this. Time is nothing but a number, and numbers is unlimited. You can count them until Jesus come home. You feel what I'm saying? I got family that's not blood, and I got blood that's not family. You feel what I'm saying? And so with that being said, y'all my niggas, and I don't even trust motherfuckers like that. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
And ghetto, no. Ghetto, no. You feel what I'm saying?
We'll recognize real, though. Eventually, real will link up. That's
exactly.
What happens.
Exactly.
Real being
and
naked together
link
links,
up.
And now I'm in a situation right now. It's going to go somewhere else. Or have you sit.
Right.
Hey, you somewhere else.
That's you know why shit. Real link up, though? You know why real link up?
Real link up.
I'm just they might not be blood. You know why
they might not be blood, but don't think they ain't family.
Because it's a preset. You know how you go to like
from records. Yeah, I started right. off with trap, right. man.
It's a preset.
For some real shit.
Right.
Really
right.
cool.
For real right. link
started
up.
Started getting money.
Right.
Oh!
You
can't
be paying attention. You just catch that.
The money over the sucker shit.
Preset in the fucking universe.
You know what I mean? We be out here. Mental music. Like, we always out.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, believe
they
that.
Don't know
shit.
That.
Yeah, believe that. Believe that. Yeah.
It's
you
a preset.
Ain't gonna blend that.
He
ain't
said
no
real nigga with real, and yeah. I just put the wisdom on it okay. for yeah. the young man. Exactly. You know why?
Exactly.
This is like a preset in Fruity Loop, a preset in Reasons.
Yeah,
a
preset in everything.
Not even that. Not even that with that.
It's a preset in the universe for real nigga with
and
real.
That, and where that preset come from?
Hold on, I want to ask.
Everything, where it come from? He made it.
Listen, listen, I want to ask Fugazi a question. Fugazi, how did it feel to test the stage today, bro?
Man,
you did
you know,
your
I'm
thing,
on
man.
I'm stage ready. I'm built, bro. Yo, you know, bro. I see.
We appreciate
I see
you
lane.
Out here today.
You feel me? I said this is a lane that out. We've been in. Ain't like we woke up yesterday and said, yeah, we gonna do this. We done put in the footwork, man.
Yeah.
For years, you can count back. It ain't even me saying it. Look back at the years, you can see the growth.
Right.
It's documented. YouTube. Which you wanna go? My space? He ain't like I'm telling you go Google.
Yeah, you're original
like,
BZ member.
Original niggas, bro. Like,
tell them how it was in them early days, really? Like we're around Colt Bogart Ghetto and them raw days.
It's like I tell niggas, like I guess what you gotta understand me. See, niggas don't understand food. I gotta tell you what well,
shout
food
out
comes
to
from, you feel what I'm saying?
Shout out to Colt Boy.
I keep it 1,000, man. I don't even keep it 100 no more. I keep it 1,000, man. I've always been up on you niggas. I come from the hustle. I come from the streets. I wasn't thinking about rapping. I was a hustler. I sold drugs. I used the studio to get away from the cops when Coke came through and said, fool, what's up? Hop in the wheel. I go to the studio with Coke just to let my drugs drop. That's
shit.
What I was doing. And there are real niggas in there. I like what I hear. I like what real niggas. They kept going. I kept going.
And then break down how niggas ain't even right back in the day.
Yeah,
like,
wait,
it was
wait,
just.
Wait, yeah, like. I'm surprised at myself. Like when Coke, we used to go through the joint, that was freestyle.
That was off the top.
Go back. I got the songs that'll show you. When you Google it, look at the
so
song.
Niggas, but talk about how niggas critique freestyles, but didn't even realize.
Yeah,
like,
ain't even realize like that's what it was. But we ain't. I mean, you know, we went in there and just freestyled over the beat, man. People pinning on pens and papers. We wasn't doing that. You mean we wasn't taking it as hard as we taking it now. You mean so. We just actually grew with that. We grew from freestyles, man. Like,
and it's the same people now. Troy, right here. He was my manager.
Was.
He was our first manager.
Yes, I was.
When he was a group, and we transitioned to BZ, and he helped us, you know, with the growth and things of that nature.
With video production, music production. Back then, we had the big 64 track boards. Oh, we had it all. We had some nice.
We came in the game independent. Troy, talk about how we came in the game independent.
Well, one of the philosophies is you should. I'm gonna tell you like this. Even if you get up and go to the block every day and hustle and sling to get your couple dollars to keep your girl mouth shut and pay a couple things, or if you get up and go to a job every day, I don't care if you make $30-$40 an hour, $8 an hour, minimum wage $7.35. It don't make a difference. If you get up and go to a job or hustle every day, it should be built in for the black man, for the black man and woman. It should be a natural fucking built, a key built in that I go to work or I go to the block, but I'm gonna do something that's independent. I'm gonna do something that's completely independent money that I don't have to answer to nobody for. If it happened on the block, it happened there. If it happened on the job, or I mean outside of a job, it happened there. But you got to do something independent. You got to buy wholesale and sell retail.
And that's the problem. Tell them about the rappers that want to get but not trying to put out. You know what I'm saying? Not trying to invest in their craft.
He's smoking right past the bitch.
Right now, stay tuned. Hold on. You're watching Closer to My Dream, the documentary.